So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So good evening, everyone. And you're all very welcome to St. Clare's. Welcome you on behalf of the Port Clare community who have joined us. Emma, who will lead us in our stations tonight. Emma, our reader. And also Mary and Karen, who will supply our music and singing for us tonight. And also we have Kira, who will do our slides, and Nicola, who has coordinated our stations at the cross tonight. Emma, being a young person, we're going to reflect on the stations of the cross in the eyes of a young person growing up and growing and going through life. And so we begin with our opening prayer. Lord, we're about to walk in prayer the way of the cross with you. You bore our faults in your body and the cross. Through your wounds may we find healing, and through your suffering may we find peace, and through your dying may we be born to everlasting life. Through your passion and death may we be brought to the glory of the resurrection. So the first station, Jesus is condemned. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus faces his accusers and accepted the sentence to die on the cross like a common criminal. Pilate condemned him to death, and Jesus was led off to begin his journey to Calvary.
Every day in our world, people are condemned. Put it on the evening news. Every time someone is rejected because of their age, colour, or creed. You see it at school too. There are kids who are constantly the butt of jokes. They look funny or talk funny, and they don't know how to dress. They just don't fit in. Jesus was one of those who didn't fit in. He did and said things that upset the people with power. The religious leaders wanted him out of the way, and Pilate, the judge, went along with them. Jesus was condemned to die in a cross. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have condemned you in others through our silence and indifference. Help us to love and welcome all others as you did. Teach us how to follow you, how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The second station, Jesus carries his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. The guards did not let Jesus off easy. Before he had to shoulder the burden of his cross, he was ridiculed, spat upon, whipped, and humiliated. Yet he persevered and picked up the cross. He picked up and carried the cross.
All around us, people are carrying heavy burdens. Sometimes we allow ourselves to be deaf and blind to the pain of others. It is easier that way. We have enough to do just taking care of ourselves. Jesus was forced to carry the burden of the cross. Surely there were those in the crowd who knew him. They saw the soldiers drop the cross on his shoulders, but they were worried about themselves. They didn't protest the rough treatment he received. They didn't come forward and defend him. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have walked away from the burdens of others. Help us not to be deaf and blind to their pain. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
The third station, Jesus falls the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Weakened as he was by the beating and the weight of the cross, Jesus fell to the ground. The soldiers roughly dragged him to his feet and pressed him onward.
The worst thing that can happen to us is to fall flat on our faces in front of others. When we do or say something stupid, or when we are not accepted for who we are. To be shut out is the worst way to fall flat. Jesus fell flat in front of the soldiers, in front of people who had believed in him, in front of his own mother. He was in this situation because he had spoken out and taken risks for others. What must he have been thinking as he fell under the cross? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have shut others out and refused to help. Help us to be aware of their needs. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Fourth station, Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Mary was following Jesus on his road to Calvary. At one point they came face to face. What could she do? What could she say to him? What words of comfort and love could overcome this terrible moment? What did he think of her now?
Parents expect so much of us. They want us to always do our best so we will succeed in life. And we want our parents to think the best of us. We don't want them to know about some things we do. Mary wanted Jesus to succeed. She wanted people to accept him, believe him, to love him. as she saw him carrying the cross, did she think that he was guilty, that he was a failure, or did she love and support him? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have resented our parents. Help us to be grateful for their love and support. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The fifth station, Simon helps Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Simon was a stranger, a foreigner in Jesus' land. He was dragged out of the crowd by the soldiers to help Jesus carry the cross. Like the Good Samaritan, he was a stranger, yet he helped the person in need.
Sometimes we are made sit beside an outsider or made help someone we wouldn't normally be caught dead with. We don't stop to think about the other person's feelings. We only care about how we feel. Poor Simon. Why was he a foreigner chosen to help this criminal carry the cross? He was probably embarrassed and humiliated to be forced into this situation. Was there even a moment when he stopped thinking of himself and looked with compassion at Jesus? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have hurt others by not caring how they feel. Show us how to act with love and compassion. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The sixth station, Veronica wipes Jesus' face. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. We don't know who Veronica was, but tradition says she came forward to the line of guards surrounding Jesus to wipe his face clean of the mud and blood and sweat that covered it. It was a thoughtful, compassionate gesture.
There are some people who always put others first. Veronica is one of those people. Her sympathy for Jesus overcame her fear of being laughed at, and she came forward to wipe the blood and sweat from Jesus' face. She didn't stop to think about the consequences or to measure her own needs. At that moment, she thought only about the needs of Jesus. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have laughed at people who stand up for and defend others. Help us to learn to accept the truth about ourselves and the things we do. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The seventh station, Jesus falls again. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus fell a second time as weariness overcame him. But the guards had no sympathy. They pulled him to his feet again and pushed him along.
None of us want to be a failure, especially in the eyes of our friends. All day we are concerned about what our friends think, and we work hard to look good in their eyes. But sometimes they fail us. They don't stand by us when we need them, in spite of all of our efforts to please them. When Jesus fell again, what were his concerns? Was he worried about how his friends were taking this? And where were they? Why didn't even one of them step forward on his behalf? What was he thinking as he fell to the ground for the second time? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have failed to be there for our friends when they needed us. Help us to be as caring as you are always for us. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Station, the women weep for Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. In the crowd that surrounded Jesus was a group of professional mourners who followed along weeping and wailing. Jesus saw them and admonished them to turn to matters that should really concern them rather than doing a lot of false weeping for him.
Sometimes things we would never do on our own seem okay when everyone else is doing them. We tend to cheer louder and even gang up more on losers when they are in the crowd. The women in the crowd who wept for Jesus were crying because the situation called for tears. Frightening things were going on. The women were too curious to leave, but too afraid to keep quiet, and so they cried. As Jesus passed by, he heard them. He told them to stop their false tears and to weep genuinely instead for the evil that is taking place around them. He was asking them to follow their hearts, not the crowd. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have gone along with the crowd and for not accepting responsibility for what we do. Help us to be genuine and to get in touch with how we really think and feel. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The ninth station, Jesus falls the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Near the end of his journey, as he travelled up the hill to Calvary, Jesus again lost his footing and fell. How hard it must have been for him to get up again and go forward, knowing what awaited him.
To be made fun of once is bad enough. To have it happen again and again is agony. Yet, it happens all the time to people in our school and all around us. And we do it too. We laugh at them when they fall down, and even laugh more when they fall again. Jesus fell three times with the cross on his shoulders. He had helped so many of the people standing around him, but not one of them had the courage to come forward and help him. Why did they let him fall? Was it because he was no longer one of them? Jesus, forgive us for the times we make fun of others. Give us the courage to lift them up when they fall, even if they don't fit in. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, without end.
Tenth station, Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Once at Calvary, Jesus was stripped of his garments and left to stand naked and alone in front of the crowd, his followers and strangers alike. How helpless and foolish he must have looked to those who believed in him. How helpless and foolish he must have felt.
Clothes are a big part of our lives. The right clothes cost a lot, but we insist on having them. We want to look right. We want to be dressed like everyone else. There are people we know that don't dress right, and we know what happens to them. Without the right clothes, they are nothing. Jesus was stripped of his clothing in front of a whole crowd of people. He stood there without the comfort and security of his clothes. He was stripped of his dignity like a criminal. How must he have felt without clothes? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have cared more for good clothes than for good people. Help us never to value designer labels more than the needs of others. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, without end. Amen.
The 11th station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. If there was a moment when Jesus realized there was no turning back, it must have been when the nails went through his hands and feet, binding him to the cross. Now there was no escape, no way to avoid death.
At times, we do things that are wrong. We call people names because they are different. We join others who laugh at them. Deep in our hearts, we know that this is wrong, but we go along with it anyway. Jesus was the victim of anger and jealousy. He had said and done things that were different. He had accepted all people equally, as they were. Now he was paying the price. There must have been those in the crowd that knew he was innocent, but they went along with the way things were. They stood by and let Jesus be nailed to the cross. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have nailed others to the cross because they are different. Show us how to love and value people as you did. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The 12th station, Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Alone, in spite of the people gathered at his feet, Jesus felt abandoned even by his Father in heaven as he breathed his last and died. At that moment, his followers surely lost all hope and faith in Jesus and in his mission.
From time to time, we all think about dying. When things aren't going so well for us, it's often easier to think about death rather than facing our problems. Is this what Jesus was feeling as he died? Was he hoping to get it over with? Or was he worried about his friends, his mother, his followers? Was he angry at God and life? What did he mean when he said, "Forgive them"? They don't know what they're doing. Was he really so unselfish that he could pray for those who hurt him? Jesus, forgive us for the times we quit too easily because we are only thinking of ourselves. Share with us the kind and unselfish courage you had. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus' lifeless body was taken down from the cross. He had died in agony, and only Joseph of Arimathea offered a burial place for him. Mary cradled Jesus in her arms and wept as his body was carried away.
Sometimes we clearly recognize a lost cause. We don't like to be part of a lost cause, but we often are. We're on that losing team. Joseph of Arimathea, a secret follower of Jesus, who was afraid of the leaders, finally came forward after Jesus had died. He claimed the body of this criminal. What made him do it? Wasn't he still afraid of being identified with a lost cause? No doubt he was ashamed for waiting so long, but at least he did something good and courageous in the end. Jesus, forgive us for the times we walk away from painful situations and the people in them. Give us the courage to act on our beliefs, no matter how afraid we feel. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The 14th station, Jesus is placed in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus was wrapped in a shroud and placed hurriedly in the tomb provided by Joseph. The soldiers and guards rolled an enormous boulder in front of the entrance to make sure that nothing happened to the body, that Jesus' followers couldn't come and steal his body and make more miraculous claims about him.
When we have worked hard at something, we expect to be rewarded. We certainly don't want to be blamed or punished for doing our best. Though this happens sometimes to people we know, and we walk away from them. We don't want to hang out with losers. Jesus spent his public life preaching, healing, and helping others. He promised good things to those who followed him. But here he was, dead from crucifixion, and apparently good things had not happened to him or those who believed in him. At this moment of sorrow and failure, his followers had abandoned him, and he was buried in another man's grave. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have measured our success by the applause and praise of others. Help us learn to look beneath the surface of things with the eyes of faith. Teach us how to follow you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Lord God, when our world lay in ruins, you raised it up again through your passion and death. Lord of the sun and the stars, we celebrate with joy the glory of your resurrection, for through it the world is flooded with light. O King of the Friday, whose limbs were stretched on the cross, O Lord, who suffered the bruises, the wounds, and the loss, we lay ourselves open to the loving kindness of your Sacred Heart. May some fruit from the tree of your passion fall upon us this day. Amen. So again, thank you for joining us this evening. Thanks again to Emma there for leading us in the stations tonight, and to Karen and to Mary. Thank you for the lovely singing music, and to Nicola and to Kira and the Poor Clares for being with us again this night. So again, I invite you to join us for our normal weekend masses. And this weekend, we will have a penitential service reflection at all of our masses. So please join us as we just focus on what we've been asked to do during Lent, to repent and to acknowledge that Jesus died on the cross so that our sins would be forgiven. So we will celebrate that forgiveness that he has for all of us. So now the Lord be with you all. May Almighty God bless you this night now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So stay safe and God bless. Good night.